All right, everybody. We are here with Britt of one of my favorite rock bands, Spoon.
Hey, how you doing, John?
How you doing, Britt?
Yeah, it's good to meet you.
Yeah, good to have you on the show today. Pleasure to see you walking the carpet. I know, I think if I'm wrong, it's your first Grammy nomination as Spoon.
First nomination, first carpet walk, and third interview. So.
Yeah, man. All right, we're getting you early. That's good, man.
Yeah.
So I got to say, Lucifer on the Sofa, I was really happy to see it nominated. And I was happy to see the name of Spoon on the nominations, as you guys have been such like a consistent rock act.
Right.
And I feel like this year something happened and the Recording Academy took notice and Lucifer on the Sofa is incredible. Could you tell me a bit about receiving that nomination and did you think it would ever come?
I was a little surprised, yeah. Mm-hmm. I mean, and when we made this record, we really set out in our minds to like make an unmistakably rock record. And I didn't know what category we'd be nominated in, but to be nominated in the rock category is pretty cool.
Yeah, definitely.
That's what I grew up listening to.
Oh, me too. Me too. I got to say, you mentioned kind of coming into the rock category this year and simplifying things a little bit and getting more rock, because I thought for the transition from Hot Thoughts to Lucifer was a bit different, right?
Yeah, it was.
That group of time, what happened during that time?
I mean, Hot Thoughts was much more of a sort of produced record,
mm-hmm.
and it was a record that like we were writing the songs as we were in the studio, mm-hmm. and we kind of decided to do it the old-fashioned way this time and like write the songs as a band, play them in a room, and then hit the record button.
Nice.
Which is, you know, not a novel idea, but it ended up being a different type of record than the one we made before.
Definitely.
It's a different sound.
Definitely. And tell me about the song Held on that record, because I was listening to that track.
It's a great song.
And I noticed, I was like, oh, that's a Bill Callahan song. Yeah, right?
Bill Callahan, who lives in Austin, where we live. And, it's just a song that we've been around for a while, and years ago we used to play that song at our live show and never recorded it.
Yeah.
And this time we just, I think one day we were in the studio and we just said, let's play this one just for fun.
Nice.
And pretty soon it was like, maybe this isn't just for fun. Like, this sounds pretty good.
Yeah.
And so no intention with it, but it ended up being, it's just a great song.
Yeah.
Great groove.
You guys did a great job of taking that Bill Callahan track and kind of like rockifying it a little bit, putting some guitars on it, changing like slight changes to the melody and stuff like that. I'd really appreciated the intricacies in which you like updated it but kept the core values of that song.
Thanks, man.
It was really cool.
Thank you.
And for Spoon, I was wondering, what's in the future? Is there anything you're excited about besides tonight?
We're doing a tour of Europe with the Black Keys this summer. And I heard maybe some other tour after that. You know, we're just be doing shows.
Hell
but,
yeah.
I got to write some songs, basically.
Okay, getting back to the songwriting.
This is interrupting my downtime to write a song, so.